You have written one time and another some sentences which have surprised me a little about death. Now, in particular, I remember you've said that death is psychologically just as important as birth, and like it, it's an integral part of life, but surely it can't be like birth if it's an end, can it?
Yes, if it's an end. And there we are not quite certain about this end. Because, you know, there are these peculiar faculties of the psyche that it isn't entirely confined to space and time. You can have dreams or visions of the future. You can see round corners and such things. Only ignorance deny these facts. It's quite evident that they do exist and have existed always. Now these facts show that the psyche, in part at least, is not dependent upon these confinements. And then what? When the psyche is not under that obligation to live in time and space alone, and obviously it doesn't, then to that extent the psyche is not submitted to those laws. And that means a practical continuation of life, of a sort of psychical existence beyond time and space.
Do you yourself believe that death is probably the end, or do you believe that?
Well, I can't say. You see, the word belief is a difficult thing for me. I don't believe. I must have a reason for a certain hypothesis. Either I know a thing, and when I know it, I don't need to believe it. If I don't allow myself, for instance, to believe a thing just for the sake of believing it, I can't believe it. But when there are sufficient reasons for a certain hypothesis, I shall accept these reasons, naturally, and should say, we have to reckon with the possibility of so-and-so, you know.
Well, now, you told us that we should regard death as being a goal.
Yes.
And that to shrink away from it is to evade life and make life purposeful.
Yes.
What advice would you give to people in their later life to enable them to do this, when most of them must in fact believe that death is the end of everything? Mm-hmm.
Well, you see, I have treated many old people, and it's quite interesting to watch what the unconscious is doing with the fact that it is apparently threatened with a complete end. It disregards it. Life behaves as if it were going on. And so I think it is better for old people to live on, to look forward to the next day, as if he had to spend centuries. And then he lives properly. But when he is afraid, when he doesn't look forward, he looks back, he petrifies, he gets stiff, and he dies before his time. But when he is living on, looking forward to the great adventure that is ahead, then he lives. And that is about what the unconscious is intending to do. Of course, it's quite obvious that we are all going to die, and this is the sad finale of everything. But nevertheless, there is something in us that doesn't believe it, apparently. But this is merely a fact, a psychological fact. Doesn't mean to me that it proves something. It is simply so. For instance, I may not know why we need salt, but we prefer to eat salt too, because you feel better. And so when you think in a certain way, you may feel considerably better. And I think if you think along the lines of nature, then you think properly.